I'm actually real proud of this.
Shocking, isn't it? Hello, people. Zap 20 Million A here, and today we are going to do a random Q&A video with another. So it's basically a vlog, but with questions and answers.
And what? We're not moving.
I am joined with
Sage Sagasage. I am a new friend. We literally just met like 2 hours ago, I think.
On the net.
3 hours.
Yeah. And you? She's out of frame.
Sienna.
Call her Sean.
I also have a friend who's upstairs right now. His name is Sean as well.
It's spelled differently, so we don't get them confused when we're talking in the group chat.
Yeah. Okay, so.
That's right. I'm letting the world know.
All right, so let's start off with the first question.
We should tell them the topic.
Okay, we have a few topics here. I got two topics that I chose and one that she chose. First topic that we're going to do is personal space. We're going to talk about personal space. Basically. That was yours, yeah. That's the one you chose. The other ones we're going to do is favorite animals. And your favorite animals, what you really like about them. We'll talk about them. We'll ask questions about them. And the last one is favorite games. Games and stuff, which is pretty fun. Also, I love this shirt. My sister got it for me for Christmas. It was awesome.
I love this sweater. Some people think it's my boyfriend's. It's not. It's mine.
No, it's mine.
No, it's not. Just because you tried to steal it once doesn't mean it's yours forever.
Fuck you. Red skin. All right.
Okay. Sean. So, let's move on to the questions. First question.
You ask me.
I'm going to ask you, and then you're going to ask me a question, okay? Yes. That's how we're going to do it for the first. Hold we're going to do, I think 5 or 6 questions on each topic. So
I think 5 is a good number.
5? Okay, cool. Okay, the first question I'm going to ask you is, what are you willing to do? Like, what are you willing to leave your comfort circle to do? Like, certain things. What are you willing?
Well.
Like, what are you willing, what are you not willing?
I want the world to hear my voice, first off. Second off, I want to be able to talk to people without breaking down afterwards. Well, people that I don't know, of course.
Yeah, when you're talking about personal stuff and things like that.
Even when I'm ordering food, I have a really tough time.
Oh, okay.
I have really high anxiety when it comes to that stuff.
If I'm rubbing my nose a lot, it's because I do have a small dog allergy and just bugs my nose.
Yeah, you love dogs.
Yeah, I love dogs. Yeah, I don't care. I love dogs.
Yeah.
All right, your turn.
If you could leave your comfort zone for anything, what would it be?
It also depends on the situation as well. My comfort zone is actually very big. Depending on what it is. Like, if it's comfort zone for doing, activities and stuff like that, it's pretty big. Like, if you're doing, outside activities and stuff like that, it's pretty big. But when it's more personal stuff, with friends and stuff like that, it's kind of limited to,
Not too depressing.
Like, nothing. If it's too depressing, if it's depressing, I'm there for you. I'll always be there for the person. I'm always there for people. I've always tried to help them. And there's a lot that I won't talk about or I won't listen to. Like, you can tell me literally anything that's been going on, and I'll listen to it. I'll listen to it, and then I'll put my own, thoughts into it.
See, I have the same problem. Well, I don't, it's...
It's not a problem.
It's not really a problem, but it's a perk, kind of.
Yeah, basically.
But to me, it's a problem, because I put all of this stuff onto me, and it stresses me out so bad. Sean, shut the fuck up.
The problem is, you gotta not, I realize this, you gotta not absorb, you can't just absorb what the person you're talking to's problems is, because they'll just add to your own problems. And I learned that the hard way.
Yeah, but I like helping people.
I do too, but I used to absorb what their pain was, so I felt the same thing.
So you're basically an empath.
Yeah, it just, it's more of a problem for you when you do that than it is with them. You have to not absorb their thing, what their problem is.
It's really hard when you sync with them.
Yeah. All right, my other question is, let's say you were...
On to the next.
Yeah, let's say you were on a bridge, okay? And people are doing bungee jumping. Three choices, okay? You could either go bungee jumping, skydiving, or simply deep sea diving. Which would you choose? This is like, which is your more comfortable to you think you'd do?
I'm afraid of falling, so I'd go with deep sea diving. I am deathly afraid of falling.
The reason why I said the deep sea diving is because a lot of people are afraid of the ocean. I've heard. It's because it's unknown. No one knows what's down there. You never know what could be down there. That's why people are afraid of sharks. Not just sharks, though.
Shark bait.
There's sharks. There's other fish that you don't know what's down there. You could, you can't. It's like really, really dark. Just saying.
Yeah, but it's also easier than falling to your death.
But if with bungee jumping, you're safe. Skydiving, you're safe too because you have a freaking parachute.
Have you ever heard the story of the girl that jumped out of the plane? It's on 1,000 Ways to Die. The freaking parachute wires got tied around their neck and...
Well, it's because they were stupid.
And there was this one person who pulled on a loose thread instead of the actual thing. I'm afraid that's going to happen to me.
Normally when you first do it, they have a person that you're strapped to who pulls it for you. No, doggy.
No, doggo!
Doggo, no. Doggo, no. Don't ruin, no. No.
Raven!
No.
Lays right on it.
Alright, okay. Your turn.
Oh, it's like, gone.
You smell like Lego.
It's gone.
What? I didn't know Legos had a smell.
It smells like plastic. Hold on, I think she actually helped with it.
Raven smells like Lego.
She's gonna roll over on it, I swear.
Oh my, stop making her move!
Stop, we're trying to record here!
Okay, Raven, go!
Pause it for the... Hey, you're gonna ask a question. The dog to go. No, doggo! Gosh darn it, I will...
Ah, my butt!
Great. Ask question.
Don't really have questions in store.
You had time to think about this.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
I was too worried about the doggo.
It was your idea with the...
Personal space?
Yeah, it was your idea.
How many times does a person have to touch you in order for you to get mad, like I just did?
It depends on how pissed off I am. If I'm really pissed and you touch me, I will freaking cut your fingers off.
It depends on it depends on my mood. If I'm in a mood where I just don't give a shit, go ahead, poke me as many times as you want. I'll just poke you back.
I'll just poke you back.
Never mind. Where is it? Oh, it's behind the camp.
Don't worry about it.
Dumbass.
Don't worry about it.
My dog's bum is warm.
Fluffy dog. That's something you don't want in a video. And I don't edit these.
Well then.
Okay, let's go.
Okay, that was only a question. We were at 4 questions.
Yeah.
So we'll do the 5th one.
No, you have to fucking answer.
He did. It depends on my mood. If I'm in the don't give a shit mood, you can poke me as much as you want. I'll just poke you back. If I'm angry, don't touch me.
Yeah, you didn't fucking say that.
If I'm sad, hug me, because I will freak out if I don't. If someone doesn't.
Like I said, if I'm really pissed off and you poke me, I'll cut all of your fucking fingers off. I'll probably murder you in your sleep too.
That's the person.
Fuck no!
She's upside down
for a second.
Okay, next question.
Alright, that's 5 questions. Really? Oh, that's four questions.
No.
We need one more question. So, you, ask
Don't
us a question.
Don't touch me.
Ask us a question on personal space.
No.
Do it.
Do it. We need a fifth question.
Frick, when you make up one, you
never We just one. Did four.
We should deserve a third. We should deserve a third opinion.
We need a third opinion. We need a third opinion.
Yeah, you're very opinionated. If that's the right word.
Yeah.
Make up a fucking question,
I can pause the video until you figure out a question.
I'm not asking you guys a question.
Just...
Okay, how close does somebody have to get to you before you push them away or kill them? Because I'd kill them.
Depends on the mood, I guess. It depends on the mood and stuff like that.
If I'm really happy, I'm generally away from people, which is very abnormal.
Normally when you're happy, you're close to people.
Unless if I'm, like, in one of those types of moods where I just want to be around people and I want to be a little social butterfly. But unless if I'm sad, I'm usually up in my room hiding with my cat because I love my cat dearly. Watching Harry Potter movies, talking to people who make me happy. Meanwhile, if I'm mad, if you fucking touch me, you better be prepared to lose a hand.
For me, I'm a very huggable guy. I love giving hugs, and I love receiving hugs. If I'm angry, I will probably be happy when people hug me, unless I'm so pissed off to the point where I will punch you.
Deadly.
Which isn't very often, because it's very hard to make me angry. And somewhat easy.
Falafel waffle.
That's just a thing. It doesn't make me angry, it's just a thing.
Fuzzy kiwi.
That's what kiwis are.
Hairy pineapple.
She whispered...
That just
she whispered
weird.
Fuzzy... Furry kiwi or whatever in my
I said fuzzy kiwi. It's Salem... It's Young Thugs in Mime's distress signal.
But yeah, like I said, if I'm really happy, I will give you a hug and make you happy. Try and make you happy, because I like to make other people happy. If I'm really depressed, hugs really actually help. They're like a best medicine, somewhat, if you think about it.
Yeah.
Alright, so, let's move on to the next topic.
Favorite animal.
Alright, is that about our questions? We're ready to start. Stop moving, dog! Gosh! It's good thing you're cute.
Okay, first question on three. 1, 2, 3.
What's your favorite animal? My favorite animal is sea turtles. I love sea turtles. They're my favorite animal in the world, and I'll always love them.
My favorite animal in the whole entire world would have to be wolves. Any type of wolf, I absolutely freaking adore. They're so fuzzy. They look so loving.
I was
loving.
Scared of wolves when
and
I
Sage,
was young.
This is why we're friends.
You love me.
Yeah.
Alright, okay, so that was the first question. Now we ask each other questions. You have to ask me one first because I asked you one last one.
Why?
Stop getting closer! Look at this fluff.
Fluff dog. What do you like most about that animal?
Sea turtles?
Yeah.
Mostly it's because if you ever see them swim and everything, they're graceful.
They're very graceful.
Basically, yeah. There's a lot of cool things I learned about them, and I really like them for, like, their turtles is one best thing I love about them, because turtles is my favorite animal, as well as, but sea turtles are the favorite out of all the turtles. Also, I want to quickly put a random fun fact. Did you know that the leatherback sea turtle is one of the biggest sea turtles in the world, and is also the only one with its type of shell? Which is like one big piece with the lines.
Mm-hmm.
And the other ones are plated.
And leatherbacks also don't have teeth. They have ridges in the back of their throats.
Which allows them to eat.
Yep.
Jellyfish.
I only know that because my sister wants to be a marine biologist when she grows up.
I wanted to be that too, but I don't want to be a game developer. So yeah, that's my answer to that question.
Your turn.
Yes. So, what is your favorite aspect of a wolf? Like, I'm not saying, like, your favorite thing about them, the aspect about them, like, if you know what I'm talking about.
Power.
In what way? Explain.
They're just a very powerful creature. Like, they have such an impact on, like,
the environment?
Indigenous cultures, and such a big impact on the environment, too. Yes, spiritually, too.
Yeah, yeah, that's true.
Out of the 7 grand, is it? Mm-hmm. Yeah, 7 grandfathers, Mayan gun is Ojibwe for wolf, which wolf means represents humility.
This is once a wolf.
A raven's just like, help me, I'm dying.
yeah, tell us a fun fact about wolves.
Fun fact is that...
I know a fun fact.
Timberwolves are very cool to hang out with.
Alright.
Sean, get your big fat head out of the way. I'm like, half black, half Native. I was just...
I can't have half black.
Alright, guys. Jeez. Sorry if it's crackling or anything, guys.
It's not black. My fault.
Half black, half
Dog, Native. No rolling over. No.
Okay.
I love you, but stop it. Don't look at my face.
Back on track.
Sorry. Alright, so that's your question. Ask me another question.
Same question you just asked, but for turtles!
Favorite aspect about them?
Yeah.
Is how gentle they are. They're not aggressive against other people. They're really gentle.
Oh yeah, sea turtles. I thought you were talking about turtles in general.
No, sea turtles. They're very gentle creatures.
I was like, snappers.
Snapping turtles can jump.
Holy shit. I was holding a baby snapping turtle once.
One of them jumped at me. It was the scariest thing ever. I thought I was for surely gonna lose a leg.
But yeah, sea turtles, they're so cute. Like, when they're babies, they're just the cutest little things ever, and they're
crawling
just...
crawling out of their little holes.
Yeah, they
just dig. Like, help me get to the water.
And then the douche animals just be like, I'm gonna eat you.
Douche-ass animals, also known as pelicans, seagulls, crabs.
Crabby! Yeah! but yeah, like, I love how peaceful they are. That's one of my favorite aspects about them. Mm-hmm. And, how the fact that they're very, like, the shells mean, like, they're defensive. They evolved to have that.
They're just like...
Also, I love how long they live.
They live for a very long time.
I want a tortoise when I grow up, so it will live longer than me.
You're already grown up, though.
No, like, I mean, like, when I have enough money for it. And grow
I'm half black.
Half Native.
All right.
I'll sit up again.
Stop blacking us out.
Fuck you guys.
Sean!
Yeah. All right, okay, that's two questions each, right?
Yeah.
Ow. Well, we were doing three each for this one, so.
What?
Yeah. You had a third question.
Oh, yeah, I did.
Yeah, you did, so.
Yeah, I'm gonna do my... moving your ass.
I did. Hey, go ahead.
Come.
So I asked, the first question I asked was aspect.
Oh, God.
No.
You're...
like a bird.
What was my first question?
Something about...
We both asked what our favorite was, and I asked you what the aspect of it was, and you asked me... the same thing, but you before that, you asked me why I liked it.
Oh,
that.
Yeah!
So, my next question, the final question I'm going to ask is, they like to be part of packs and everything like that. What do you know about these packs when they are in packs? Go ahead, answer if you wish.
Okay, so... When wolves travel, the elders are the sick ones are in the front, and then there's the five strongest, and then they have, like, the pups and the rest of the pack, and then another five strongest, and then the alpha's at the back so you can watch all over the pack.
Yeah. And they're also loyal as fuck.
Yeah.
They are.
It just blew up!
Someone's have. That's the next topic. Video games. All right. Piece of shit. You can answer the next question if you want.
Twat kick muffin, Dad.
Okay. I personally made that up.
What do you like about the pack part of the wolves and everything? Like the fact that they have packs and everything. No, like there are a lot of serious. There's a lot of good answers for this. There is an answer I have.
What I like most about packs is that they never leave anyone behind. Like, even if they're sick, like Sean mentioned, they never leave them behind. They put them in front. Like, put them in front of all their problems.
Yeah, like, they put them in front that way that they move at their pace.
They move at their pace. So, what I like about them when they're packed, the instincts and stuff like that is. What are you talking about?
My eyebrow, it hurts.
Oh, okay. But I would say, what I like about them, especially when they're hunting. It's when they're hunting. Because if they hunt alone, if they hunt small animals, it's easy. But if they're hunting big animals, they can easily get injured or killed.
That's why they hunt in packs.
That happened to my brother's dog, Diesel. He is part King German Shepherd and part Timberwolf. I don't know how they got together.
We are running out of time. We need to hurry up. We need to move on to the next one. So
Diesel ran after a deer, and there was blood on his tag. We searched his body for it, like, for an open wound. We look at Diesel. We look outside our window, and Blaine and I look at each other, and we were like, there's either a dead or a wounded deer out there.
Dog, don't be so close to the camera. Okay, so we got to move on quick, because we're running out of time for this video. And no! Stop it! Yeah. All right, so last thing, we're not going to ask a lot of questions about this because I would like to do this in a different video. We're going to talk about our favorite games. We're not going to talk about very long about them, just something like, just think of one of your favorite games from like when you were younger or when you're around now.
Yes, from
when so I will ask you first, what was your favorite game when you were younger and why?
My favorite game when I was younger was Racing ATV. Or whatever. I forget the name. I haven't played it in such a long time, and I miss it so much.
The Racing ATV games?
Yeah. We used to play it on our little PS2 that we still have, and we still have games for it. And we used to listen to Eminem a lot, and when I was little, I used to be able to talk really fast, like faster than I can right now, and I used to be able to rap all of the songs that we would listen to. And I'd just be, like, playing the little game, and my brother would walk in, and he would look at me, like, this is my older brother, of course, he's 12 years older than me. He walks in, and he's like, I am so proud I showed you this game, and I'm so proud that you listen to Eminem when you're playing it, because Eminem just really hypes me up, you know?
But why is it your favorite game?
Because it's about racing, and it brings back a lot of memories. Like, I remember this one place where it was, like, a logging area, and there was like planes and stuff and transports that would come, and Sky and I, my 1 year old brother that everybody thinks that we're twins.
1 year old.
Yeah, 1 year older brother that everybody thinks we were meant to be twins. We used to play it all the time, and we would wait at the little log bridge, and like it was quite a bit far away from where the transports would come, so we would race the transports to wherever they were going. And I remember when we used to go through the tunnels, it would suck because we'd always regenerate somewhere else because we weren't allowed. And we'd always get so mad. We want to know where the transport's
going. I like in a bunch of games like that, like you find a really cool spot, but then when you wipe out in that spot, you like somewhere
else.
You're
just else like, God damn! Like where was it?
Yeah. Alright, you gotta ask me a question quick because we are running out of time.
What is your current favorite game?
Current favorite?
On your current favorite console.
Okay, so my current favorite game on the 360, the console I like to play on, is and will always be Halo. I've talked about this with Unknown Krabs before. in a different video. Check out his channel. You'll find it. And we are really running out of time. And the reason why I like this game is because ever since I was a little kid, I played it on the original Xbox. I had a lot of fun with it.
Yes.
Like, I played the first game. I've played second, third, fourth, fifth, and not the fifth yet. Halo Reach, Halo Wars, and Halo 3 ODST. They're all really good games. I really enjoy them. I love the story to them. Some people may say that the story is shit in some of them, but they're not. I really enjoy them. It's really good. I also like the gameplay. It's like the only first-person shooter I enjoy. Because I love playing role-playing games, real-time strategies, and all those other type of games a lot more. But Halo is one of the only ones that I love. The first-person shooter part of it is a great story. And Halo Wars is one of my favorite real-time strategy games. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So, any closing remarks?
Huh?
Any closing remarks before we end the video?
No.
No? None for you?
Sage, by the way, it's 11:13. I don't know when you gotta be home.
Yeah. Any closing remarks before we end the video?
I suck at making questions. And if you were wondering what was on my wrist, it's basically an anchor that says, I've hit rock bottom, you can't see the rock bottom because I'm a dumb fuck.
Try not to break her arm to do this.
Try not to break my arm. Do I really look that frail?
I'm just saying, a lot of, okay, look how thick my arm is, and look how her arm is thin.
Excuse me.
Okay.
It looks like a pencil.
Look at that. That is two things. Eat some meat.
Holy cow. She's so white.
Eat some meat. Alright, that's it for this video. I hope you guys all enjoyed this video. And like, favorite, and subscribe if you want to anyway. And this has been
Sage Sagasage.
That's
and Sean.
I'm Sean.
And I'll see you guys all in the next video. Derp 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 derp. Peace. Bye.